Yes, good afternoon to all.
We are going to discuss about the organic quality analysis. So here we have to take 8 practicals. And here, firstly, I will discuss the theory behind that one. So that most of the questions they will ask in exam, generally it depends upon the theory. If your theory is correct, then even without doing the practical, you can complete, you can write those practicals. Why? Because you have done already this practical in the basic first year and second year, and same practical is in your second year. As the syllabus has changed, the second year syllabus, you'll find that whatever TY syllabus is there, means that is the binary mixture. So it is for the second year. So last time in the second year, I think you was having the binary mixture. Yes. Yes. Anyone of
yes,
you?
Sir.
Binary mixture, na? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Binary mixture, na?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Means you have the binary mixture. Means you know this practical. So it is not so hard. So what you'll do? We'll explain the theory behind that one in short, because even though if you explain the theory in short also, it may require again maybe 1 to 2 lectures. So I think you may have the book. So today I am not putting it as a PDF. Just I will discuss the steps involved in the organic qualitative analysis. Organic qualitative analysis, and then we'll take mixture one by one. We'll take one mixture. I will tell you how to write their explanation in your notebook, even though without doing practical. If you know the mixture, then also you can write everything. Okay, so let us see. Just I will share the screen. I think you can see my screen. So practical is organic qualitative analysis. Organic qualitative analysis. Right, so here in the previous case, when the mixture was given near about from 1 gram to 10 gram, so that time it was called as a macro analysis. It was called as a macro analysis. So for this one, you have to use a big test tube. You have to take the more compound, and you have to take that test. So the chemicals required were more. In the previous case, when we were in the BSc or MSc, that time we have done the macro analysis. There we have learned this practical on the macro analysis. It means we have to take the big test tube, and the sample that we get maybe from 1 gram, right? Maybe to 10 gram. So quantity is more. As the students were less, that time as the strength was less, so we used to do that practical. And after that one, as you know that it's a student's tendency that after doing the test, everything we have to throw, we can in the either dustbin or in the sink. So there was a question of the pollution. So what happened? Again, this quantity has reduced, means the sample given to you maybe from 10 milligram to 100 milligram, 10 milligram to 100 milligram, and it is called as a semi micro analysis. Semi micro analysis. So, this is the method for you. So, we are carrying out this method. So the sample or the mixture given to you will be from 10 milligram to 100 milligram, means it is not also 1 gram, right? And again, when you go to the MSc or that time, again, this quantity will get reduced. It will from 1 milligram to 10 milligram. And it is called as a microanalysis. Microanalysis. So, generally it will for the MSc, and again when you go to the that is the resource level, that time when the compounds are very, very costly, that time generally we are using less than 1 milligram, less than 1 milligram. So it is called as a ultra micro analysis. Ultra micro analysis. So which method you are using? We are using the semi micro analysis for the TY BSc. Even for the FY SYTY means for the BSc, now we are using the semi micro analysis. So it is your duty to do that practical according to that one. Generally what students they are doing, they are using the big test tube and they are taking the more quantity. So whenever you do any test, that test a complete test should not be more than half of the test tube. So this is your test tube, right? So in this test tube, when you add the mixture and when you take compound, so it should not be more than half of the test tube. So here again this test tube is very, very small, so it is called as a semi micro analysis. So what are the advantages? The advantage is that this technique is very quick, and even though the when the students are beginners, means they don't know anything, you can also become a master in that one. You can understand very easily. The sample that you are using near about from 10 milligram to 100 milligram, and it is called as a semi micro analysis. And we are using the small glassware. So the reagents or the samples that we are using, it should be very pure, and it should be the AR grade. And generally, after a complete test, generally the test tube should not be more than 1/2 or maybe 1/3 also. 1/2 or 1/3 also. Okay, so it is the semi micro analysis. Now here, in the BSc first year, we have learned only a single compound. One compound has been given, and we have learned the organic qualitative analysis. Right. So what is the organic qualitative analysis? In the organic qualitative analysis, so it is a branch of chemistry which is concerned with the finding of elements and the chemical composition of the unknown substances. Means a compound is given to you, maybe mixture or maybe single compound. So we have to find out which elements there it present, whether it contains nitrogen, sulfur, or maybe halogen. So you have to find out the elements present in that one and what is their chemical composition. So here again we are taking only few tests, and we have to find out what is the structure or a name of the compound from the given data, from the given test. So it is called as a organic qualitative analysis. So what is the organic qualitative analysis? Organic qualitative analysis is a branch of chemistry which is concerned with the finding of elements and chemical composition of the unknown substance, is called as organic qualitative analysis. And here the analysis may be on the macro and analysis means we are taking the more quantity from 1.1 gram to 10 milligram. Same micro that we are using 10 milligram to 100 milligram. Generally in the MSc we are using 1 milligram to 100 milligram. So here we are using test tube. So when you use capillary, right, you know the capillary, right? It just is small. For the student vision test, you can take a capillary. So you have to carry out the same test in the capillary, right? So here we can use the micro analysis and ultra micro analysis on the computer. We are using this ultra micro analysis. So we are going to carry out the reaction in the syringe. Okay, so this is about the just in short what is I mean by organic qualitative analysis. Now for your syllabus, you are having the binary mixture. You are having the binary mixture. What is the binary mixture? Means it is a mixture of two compound. It is a mixture of two compound, and we have to find out the name of those two compounds. So it is a organic qualitative analysis. So here there are some steps involved in this organic qualitative analysis. So here first you will see the systematic analysis of the binary mixture. So systematic analysis of binary mixture. Analysis of binary mixture. As you have done already this practical, so it is not new to you. So the first step, you have to find out the nature of mixture. Firstly, we have to find out the nature of mixture. Nature of mixture, right? Second, we have to find out the type of mixture. Type of mixture. After finding out nature, you have to go for the type of the mixture. Number three, after that one, after finding the mixture, you have to go for the separation. You have to go for the separation. So next is the separation of mixture into two components. And up to this step is very important. So these three steps are very important. And after separation, you are having two compounds separately, then you have to go for its purification. Why? Because compound may not be pure. So you have to go for the purification of, that is the compound, purification. Purification. And when the compound become pure, you are having two separate compound, then what you can do? We can go for the physical constant, means you can determine it's a physical constant. Physical constant. We can find out its physical constant, means we have to find out its melting point or the boiling point. Melting point or the boiling point. And after finding out the melting point and boiling point of the separate two compounds, then we can take one by one compound and we can go for the individual analysis of this compound. So the next part is the individual analysis of the compound. So from this one we go separately. So you are having two compound, we'll take first compound number one, and you have to go for the individual analysis. Individual analysis. Analysis of two compounds separately. Right? So you have to take one compound, you have to do its complete analysis. After complete analysis, then you have to take the second compound and again you have to carry out its complete analysis. Here the students are committing mistake. What they are doing, suppose if they do first test, that is the compound is first one, and we have to go for the preliminary test. Preliminary test. So what they are doing, they are writing or they are doing the test for the first compound, and again they are going for the second compound, and they are writing simultaneously. So don't do like this one. So firstly take the one compound and carry out all this test. So first step is the preliminary test. Second is the sodium fusion test or a detection of element. Detection of elements. Detection of elements. Now third step, after detection of element, you have to go for the detection of the functional group. You have to find out the detection of functional group. Functional group. And when you find out the functional group from the above data, just you can write its CT, or even if you don't write a characteristic test for this functional group, it also work. And then you have to go for the number 7, that is the what is the literature survey. And after literature survey, means from the melting point, boiling point, and from this one we can find out the structure of the compound, or you can write down the result, right, by using literature survey. Literature survey means at the end of this practical, they have given the melting point of the compounds, and here you are having the melting point. We can match the melting point, we can check the remaining data, presence of the elements, presence of the functional group, and we may say that it may be the this compound, but it is not expected from you. But if you write, it is good, right? You should give the reason that how you have written the name of this compound. So these are the important step in this practical. So here, firstly, you have to find out the nature of the mixture. Second, you have to find out the type of the mixture. Third, you have to go for the separation. After separation into compound, you have to as the while separation, sometimes compound A and suppose compound B. So some compound B mix with compound A, or some compound A mix with compound B. So you are having the impurity. So you have to go for the purification. So you are having the one method called as a crystallization. By using the crystallization, we can go for the purification. After purification, the compounds are very pure. Then you can take its melting point or the boiling point, depending upon the nature. And after melting point, boiling point, then you can go for the individual analysis. Means up to fifth, we have to take with mixture, right? And from the sixth, you have to take one by one compound. You take first compound, you take its individual analysis. Means you have to take the preliminary test, then detection of element, functional group, and then you have to write down the result. So in this way, you have to do this practical. Okay. So these are the steps involved in the organic qualitative analysis. Sometimes they may ask, write down or tell me the steps involved in the organic qualitative analysis. First step, nature. Second step, type of mixture. Third step, separation of the mixture. Fourth, purification. Fifth, physical constant. Sixth, individual analysis. In that one, first one, preliminary test. Second one, detection of element. And third one is the detection of the functional group, and write down the result. Or we can take also CT also, but there is no need to take CT. In this way, yeah, how to do this practical. Okay. Now here, as we have said that we are having the binary mixture, means it is a mixture of two compound. Binary means it is a mixture of two compound. So first step is the nature of mixture. We have to find out the nature of mixture. So here in the first step, how we can find out the nature of mixture? So first step is the nature of mixture. Nature of mixture. Here I will take the theory part. Later on, after completing theory, I will give the demonstration only for the three compound. And for the remaining one, you have to try it yourself. Okay. Again, we'll take the only few compounds or few tests only. Nature of mixture. So you know the states of matter. One is the solid, second is the liquid, and third is the gaseous. So for your syllabus only, solid and liquid is there, right? So here the mixture, the binary mixture, that can be, right? So binary mixture, it may contains solid or it may contains liquid. So depending upon that one, we can prepare a mixture. So mixture may be solid plus solid, right? Second, it may be the solid plus liquid, and third, it may be liquid plus liquid. So out of three, you may have one. So what you'll do, I'll give a demo on one solid plus solid, second solid plus liquid, and third, that is the liquid plus liquid. Means one of the compound, or in first case, both compounds are solid. In the second case, one compound is solid and other compound is liquid. And third case, that is the one compound is liquid and other compound is also liquid. So firstly, you have to find out. That is the first step is the nature, right? First step is the nature of the compound. So it is the step number one. It is the step number one. So how to find out the nature? Either it is a S plus S, S plus L, or L plus L. So here, what you have to do, if it is a S plus S, means solid plus solid, of course, just by the physical appearance, by the by seeing the our by naked eyes. In a small beaker, generally in the plastic beaker, so the compound is given to you. And suppose if the compound mixture is solid, means we can say that it is a solid plus solid. So first part is easy. Second one, now if it is solid plus liquid, then how to find out solid plus liquid, how to find out? So what happened, the solid compound may dissolve into liquid. Suppose in the beaker, suppose what happened, some solids may not dissolve. At the bottom, you are having some particles, right? And the remaining part is a liquid. So at bottom, you are having some solid and here is liquid. So you may say that it may be the solid plus liquid, right? Solid plus liquid. But sometimes what happens, the solid compound completely dissolve into the liquid. Solid compound completely dissolve into liquid. Then how to find out that it is a solid plus a liquid? So here what you do, we have to take watch glass, right? You know, you are having a circular, here is a glass plate, here is a circular glass plate, and here is your supposed mixture. Just you can take a glass rod, right? You can take a glass rod. So just you take a glass rod, and from this glass rod, just you put some drops of mixture, some drops of this mixture. Suppose the mixture is solid plus liquid, solid plus liquid. So what happen if a mixture is a solid plus liquid, liquid the given to you, it is a volatile, generally it is a volatile. And what is meant by volatile liquid? Yes, anyone can tell? Rohit, what is meant by volatile liquid? Rohit, yes,
which liquid is evaporate,
right? The liquid which can evaporate at room temperature, the liquid which can evaporate at room temperature is called as a volatile liquid. And if you take the petrol, diesel, so as soon as if you open the cork, will find that it get evaporate and you can get a smell of that one. These are the volatile liquid. Then acetone, it is a volatile liquid. Alcohol, it is a volatile liquid. So you can get a smell of that one, means they are the volatile. So the liquids which evaporate at room temperature having the lower boiling point, so they are called as a volatile liquid. So they may ask, what are the volatile liquid? Give some examples of the volatile liquid. So all these things they will ask in the oral or in the exam. So you should know theory behind that one. How many mixtures, how many types of mixtures are there? Solid plus solid, solid plus liquid, liquid plus liquid. There are three types of mixture. The states of the matter, solid, liquid and gas. But here we are having only solid plus liquid. And the nature is three, solid plus liquid, solid plus solid, solid plus liquid and liquid plus liquid. So here what happen, when you take a mixture, and when you put on the glass plate, when you put on the glass plate, so just you have to put some drops. As the liquid is volatile, it get evaporate. It get evaporate and some small particles will remain on the plate. So you may say that it is a solid plus liquid. It is called as a solid plus liquid. But suppose the mixture is liquid plus liquid, liquid plus liquid. So what happen when you put the drops on this glass plate? So in this case, when you put some drops, and if it is a solid plus liquid, then what happen at room temperature? At room temperature, it get evaporate. It get evaporate, and on this glass plate, you are not having any droplets, right? Means you may say that it is a liquid plus liquid. It is a liquid plus a liquid. So in this way, we can find out the nature of the mixture. So first step, you have to find out the nature of mixture. So how can you find out the nature of the mixture? So here, you have to take the mixture. You have to put on the glass plate. When you put on the glass plate, so you can at room temperature, suppose if the liquid get evaporated and some solid particles remains on this plate, you may say it is solid plus liquid. And if you are not getting solid, when both liquids get evaporated, then you may say that it is a liquid plus liquid. Sometimes what happen at room temperature also, the liquids may not get evaporated. So what you can do, we can take a wire gauge, right? You know the wire gauge, right? So we can heat it, and on this heated wire gauge, we can put this plate. So when it is hot, then what happen? The liquid get evaporated, and when there is no solid, then you can say it is a liquid plus liquid. So in this way, you have to find out the nature of mixture. So here we have taken the first, the nature of mixture. Now here is solid liquid or liquid liquid. This is the nature of a mixture. Now next step is type of mixture. Number two, when you find out the nature, right, then you have to find out what is the type of mixture. What is the type of mixture? So there are four types of the compound. There are four types of the compound. One compound is either it may be the acid. It may be number two, that is the phenol. Next, number three, maybe here is a base. And number fourth is neutral. Right? There are the four types of the orange compound. They may ask, how many types of the orange compounds are there? There are the four types of the organic compound. One is acid, second is the phenol, third is the base, and fourth is the neutral. You should know their definitions, their general representation. Acid, R, C, double bond, O, OH. Then phenol, PH, OH. Base, here is R, N, S2. And neutral do not have the functional group. So example, aldehydes, ketone, here is aldehyde, or maybe ketone, or amide, R, C, double bond, O, NS2. When it is not acid or a phenol or base, it is a neutral compound. Okay. Now here, these are the four types of the orange compound. We have to prepare the mixture of this compound. So how many combinations are there to prepare a mixture, that you have to find out. So first, maybe acid, we can take the next is the phenol, right? Acid plus phenol. Next is the acid, we can add a base, acid plus base. First is acid, we can add a neutral. So these are the three combinations by using the acid. So this is the first category. Right, so acid plus phenol, acid plus base, or acid plus neutral. These are the three category. Number two, we can take phenol and we can add a base. Phenol plus base, phenol plus neutral. These are the again two category, right? And number three, we can go with a base plus neutral, right? And next one is neutral plus neutral. Neutral plus neutral. So total, so 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there are the seven mixtures are possible. There are the seven mixtures are possible. Means when you go for the type of the mixture, out of seven, there is a one. Out of seven, there is a one. So either it is from the number 1, 2, 3, or 4. So out of four, there is a one type is present. So here, we'll see how to find out the type of the mixture. So this second step is very important. If you know the second step, then everything is very easy. Only first step, the nature of the mixture. The second step, the type of mixture. After finding out the type, you have to go for the separation. And when you go for the separation, when you separate into two compounds, then you have to go for the individual analysis. So most of the questions they ask up to step number two and step number three. Step number two or step number three. So these are the some types of mixture. There are the seven types of the mixture. Vaishnavi, can you tell me any one example of acid? Vaishnavi, any one example of organic acid? Ankita Gilibile, any one example of organic acid? Yes. Ankita Verma, any one example of organic acid? Yes, we can tell. Anyone example of organic acid?
Carboxylic acid, sir.
Carboxylic acid is the organic acid, but I am asking example. Yes, you are right. Carboxylic acids are the organic acid, but we have to tell any one example of the...
Sir, acetic acid?
Which one? Yes, Vishal.
Acetic acid, sir.
Yes, acetic acid, benzoic acid, cinnamic acid.
Uric acid.
Which one?
Uric acid,
acetic acid. All the carboxylic acids are the organic acids. All the organic acids are the carboxylic acids are the organic acids. Okay, so you have to remember at least two examples of acid: phenol, base, and neutral. Phenol, alpha naphthol, beta naphthol. You have to remember the name also and the structure also. Remember, you have to remember name and also structure also. Everything is given in your book also. Then examples of base. Phenol, here, just I will write the examples, means here only we complete that point. So you know this example. Here is a benzoic acid. There's a benzene, pi bond, and there is a COOH. COOH, it is your benzoic acid. You have learned all these acids in the semester one, first topic. Then cinnamic acid, here there is a pi bond. If there is COOH and if there is OH, it is called as a salicylic acid. Suppose there is a benzene and there is a CH, double bond CH and COOH. It is called as a cinnamic acid. And in this way, we can write down the number of examples. So at least remember two to three examples of acid. Then examples of phenol. Here is a benzene. Right? Here is a benzene. And again, there is one more benzene. And here at one, there is OH is called as alpha naphthol. And at beta, there is OH is called as a beta naphthol, alpha naphthol and beta naphthol. So alpha naphthol and is your beta naphthol. Okay, so here in this way we have to write down alpha naphthol and beta naphthol. Then base, here these are the amines. Amines are the organic bases. Simple example is your aniline. NH2 directly attached to the benzene nucleus is your aniline. Then just you put the some substituents on there, you get the number of examples. So here, if suppose there is NH2 and there is NO2, right? NO2, then here we can say that it is your para nitro aniline is your base. And examples of neutral, so just now we have taken the example acetone, CH3, C double bond O, CH3, acetone, then benzaldehyde, aldehydes and ketones. These are the neutral compound. Aldehydes and ketones, these are the neutral compound. Alcohol, C2H5OH is your neutral compound. So in this we can write down their name and structure of this compound. Now you know some examples of acid, phenol, base, and neutral. So there are the four types of the orange compound. So depending upon the type, we can prepare how many mixture? We can prepare the 7 mixture. So they'll ask, write down or tell me how many mixtures are possible for the four types. And here the mixture neutral can be given, but we cannot give mixture acid plus acid, base plus base, or phenol plus phenol. We cannot give this mixture, but we can give neutral and neutral. And why? Because here the neutral plus neutral mixture that you will give, it will be the solid plus liquid or liquid plus liquid. But here in the solid, what happened? The separation depends upon the chemical method. Means by using the chemicals, you have to go for the separation. But here the neutral, the one of the compound, either it is solid liquid or the liquid. So here the separation depends upon the physical method. Physical method means depending upon the physical constant, either melting point or boiling point, you have to go for the separation. So that's why here the mixture neutral plus neutral can be given, but not the A plus A, B plus B, or P plus P. Okay, so this is about the 7 type of the mixture. And now here we have seen the type of the mixture. Then we have to find out if suppose mixture number 1 is there, means of A type, one type, A plus P, A plus B, or A plus N. So if such type of the mixtures are there, then how to find out the type of the mixture? If the second, third, or fourth type of is there, then how to find out the type of the mixture? So here we have to find out the type of the mixture, right? You have to find out the type of mixture. So the second step is your type determination, type of mixture. You have to find out the type of mixture. Okay. So here you should know the theory behind that one. If you know the theory behind that one, then very easily we can find out the type of mixture. So it required a continuous, maybe again 1 hour. If you know this one, how to find out the type, remaining part is very, very easy. The remaining part is very, very easy. And if possible, we can go for the type of the mixture with the demonstration, right? So I think here only we'll stop, and in the next